Deke Entertainment was an international film and television production company that is mostly associated as an animation studio. The company was founded in 1971 by Jean Chalopin, but on July 23rd, 2008, the company was merged with and folded into Cookie Jar. So, what went wrong for Deke Entertainment? Well, let's find out. Deke Audiovisuel, from 1971 to 1982. Diffusion Information Communications, which actually stood for Deke, was formed in France, 1971, by Jean Chalopin as the production division of Radio Television Luxembourg, a long existing media company. In 1981, Deke established a partnership with the Japanese animation studio Tokyo Movie Shinsha as one of the overseas animation subcontractors. They would help animate many of their programs, starting with Ulysses 31. They would also produce the unaired pilot Lupin VIII. This partnership would last until 1985. Launch of American Arm from 1982 to 1986. Deke's American Arm was founded in April 1982 in Burbank, California by Andy Hayward, a former story writer at Hanna-Barbera, to translate Deke productions into English. The company produced television animation for both network broadcast and syndication, outsourced its non-curative work overseas, enforced anti-union policies and hired staff on a per-program basis to cut costs. For some in the industry, Deke stood up for Do It Cheap. With directors Bruno Biasi and Bernard Dirathies, Chalopin and Hayward were able to make Deke an effective but restrained animation company. Soon after joining Deke, Hayward developed Inspector Gadget, which became a successful production out of the American office. Deke partnered with toy makers and greeting card companies for character-based product lines that could be made into animated series. Thus, Deke Productions came with built-in advertisers and sometimes financiers. Between Inspector Gadget, the latter produced for ABC, the company became profitable. As the only non-union animation firm in 1984, Deke faced an ununionization effort which failed. In 1985, Deke opened its own Japan-based animation facility for animation production on their shows in order to bypass overseas animation subcontractors, thus ending their relationship with CMSF. In April 1986, Deke launched a syndicated blog called Studio TV with LBS Communications and Mattel. Moved to North America and Andy Hayward's ownership from 1987 to 1993. From late 1986 to 1987, Hayward, along with investors Bear Stearns and company Prudential Insurance Company, bought Chalopin and Radio Television Luxembourg's 52% stake in Deke in a $70 million leveraged buyout, and made the U.S. headquarters the company's main base of operations. After the buyout, Chalopin, Banshee Diaries, and producer Tetsu Katayama left the company to be replaced by Robbie London and Michael Milani as key employees. After selling his shares of Deke, Chalopin retained Deke's original offices in France and formed the company C&D Creativity and Development in 1987 to continue producing animated shows. After the buyout, Deke was heavily in debt, and the foreign rights to the Deke library were sold in 1987 to Saban Productions, who then sold the rights to Chalopin C&D. At the time, Hayward considered Chalopin an enemy because of the purchase, and the situation permanently poisoned Deke and Saban's relationship. Deke sued Sabin for damages. In 1991, both companies reached a settlement. By 1987, Deke Enterprises' parent company was known as Deke Animation City, Incorporated. Deke also entered the toy industry with the development of the Old MacDonald Talking toy line. In December, Deke arranged a deal to merge with a Computer Memories Incorporated, a former computer components manufacturer and then public shell company. A dissident Computer Memories shareholder scuttled the deal in February 1988. With the buyout, debt still a burden, the animation market beginnings to soften with the rise of videotape viewing of new shows and new kids' cable channels. Japanese contract animation companies' rates increased 40% from 1986 to 1988 due to the yen exchange rate. In 1987, Deke moved production of Dennis the Menace to a Canadian animation firm for grants and tax breaks from the Canadian government. The company started moving some work to Korea and Taiwan. By the 1987 to 1988 season, Deke had shows on all three major networks Saturday mornings, 6 half-hours of shows, and 50 half-hours per week in syndication. Prudential Insurance Company purchased additionally equity of Deke Animation City in August 1989, while increasing Deke's debt capacity. For the 1989-1990 season, Deke provided 30% of the network Saturday morning schedule with a total 60 hours per week on networks, local station, and cable channels. 4 new programs debuted that season on cable and syndication. On September 11, 1989, Deke launched the 26 hours a week Funtown programming block on CBN Family Channel. Deke was also to produce 4 specials, with the first launching on Funtown with others, mostly holiday specials, for the fourth quarter of 1989. A special based on the new Arkies was slated for the first quarter of 1990. Throughout the early 1990s, Deke entered into partnerships with the Italian studio Retalia S.p.A., the Spanish network Telenico, both owned by the Finevis Group, and co-produced shows with them both. In 1993, Deke started up an educational unit as well as a multimedia /game unit called Deke Interactive. With this, the company moved their headquarters to a larger building in the Burbank area. Limited partnerships with Capital City /ABC and the Walt Disney Company from 1993 to 2000. In 1993, Deke Animation City and Capital City /ABC formed a joint venture called the Deke Entertainment LP, with Hayward retaining a small ownership of stake. Deke Animation City was supposed to maintain independence, but was folded into the limited partnership a year later. The partnership was later renamed to Deke Productions LP in 1994. In 1994, Deke launched a live-action television unit. In the same year, Deke and Capital City /ABC launched two children's blocks, Dragon Club and Panda Club, in China. In October 1995, Deke Productions LP announced they would be opening an animation office in France in partnership with Hamster Productions, which at the time was 33% minority owned by Deke's majority owner, Capital City /ABC. In March 1997, the studio was opened up and was named Les Studios Tex, which Deke was a shareholder in. In January 1996, Deke became part of the Walt Disney Company conglomerate following Disney's accusation of Capital City /ABC. In the same year, the company launched a feature film unit known as Deke Films and signed a first look deal with Walt Disney Pictures, which was later extended in 1998. Deek launched a direct-to-video division in April 1998 with Riley Catherine Ellis, a Carvin Pictures producer hired as a division head. The first release planned was Madeline Lost in Paris in spring 1999, with all the division's DVDs to be released by Buena Vista Home Entertainment. In 1998, Deek signed a deal to provide a children's programming block, Freddy's Firehouse, for the PaxNet television network. Re-independence from 2000 to 2004. In 2000, an investment by Bain Capital and Chase Capital Partners, Hayward purchased back Deek Entertainment LP from Disney. In February 2001, Deek announced their return to the home video market, forming a new division titled Deek Home Entertainment, and begun releasing products starting in May 2001. However, this was delayed due to Deek's problems in finding a distributor partner, which would happen in July 2001, when Deek signed a deal with Lionsgate Home Entertainment for North American distribution of Deek Home Entertainment products. In June 2001, Deek announced they would purchase Golden Books Family Entertainment for $170 million. However, Deek eventually backed up of the deal due to the high costs of the purchase, and the company was instead co-purchased by Random House for the book rights and Classic Media for the entertainment rights. In July 2002, Deek purchased the Mommy and Me preschool label. In January 2003, Deek announced three syndicated children's programming E/I blocks called Deek Kids Network. In April, Deek sued Speed Racer Enterprises, alleging that CRE had sublicensed the worldwide exploitation rights for the Speed Racer to Deek that the previous year, and then ended the agreement without Deek knowing. Later in July, Deek signed a television production deal with POW Entertainment for Stan Lee's Secret Super 6, a series about teens with alien superpowers who are taught about humanity by Lee, going public in final years from 2004 to 2008. In 2004, Hayward purchased Bain Capital's interest in Deek and took Deek public the following year under the United Kingdom Alternative Investment Market under the symbol DQL. In 2005, Mexico City-based Animinas Estudios considered forming a partnership with Deek, but decided against in order to focus on its own projects. In March 2006, Deek reacquired the international rights to 20 of their shows from the Walt Disney Company and Jetix Europe, who had owned them since Disney bought the previous owner's Saban Entertainment in 2001. In June 2006, the company acquired the Copyright Promotions Licensing Group. In June 2006, Jeffrey Adele joined Deek as president and COO. Deek Entertainment, KOL, and AOL's Kids Online, and CBS Corporation agreed to a new 3-hour-long programming block for Saturday mornings on CBS called KOL Secret Slumber Party, which launched on September 15, 2006. On September 15, 2007, a new programming block, KEW Lopalos, premiered a joint venture between Deek, CBS, and American Greetings. In April 2007, Deek Entertainment, Nelvana, and NBC Universal Global Networks announced plans to launch KidsCo, a new international children's entertainment network. In October 2007, Deek sued the damn company, claiming the alleged claims of fraud in the inducement of misrepresentations in the connection with Damn's Troll Doll and Deek's Trolls, which was curated after Deek licensed the brand from Damn. Damn countersued Deek, claiming that the company financially misrepresented its ability to curate and market a modern troll doll toy campaign and destroyed the image of goodwill of the doll. Cookie Jar Group purchase 2008/DHX Media purchase 2012. On June 20th, 2008, Deke Entertainment and Cookie Jar Group announced an agreement to merge. President Jeffrey Adell was instrumental in closing the deal and led a merger with Cookie Jar. The merger was completed on July 23rd, 2008, and the company became a subsidiary of Cookie Jar Entertainment. Shortly after the purchase, the Cookie Jar would fold Deke into their own operations. Cookie Jar was in turn acquired by DHX Media on October 22nd, 2012. And there is a history of Deke Entertainment. So, what went wrong? Well, if you look at it this way, they have been sued by multiple companies like Saban and Dam. With Saban taking Deke as an enemy and Dam with the whole Trolls doll thing. And also, with the end of Deke Entertainment, they were acquired by Cookie Jar, and they got merged and folded in with them. And as we all know, Cookie Jar didn't really do too well because they didn't really have too many good shows. And Cookie Jar actually went bankrupt and then got merged into DHX Media. But in all perspectives, Deke Entertainment had made some really good shows. They made Inspector Gadget. They made the Mario and Sonic cartoons in the 1980s and 90s. And they also made Dennis the Menace and Wish Kid. And they also made The Littles. And they also made a whole bunch of other memorable shows like Liberty Kids. And the list goes on and on and on with multiple shows that they have produced, which are remembered by many people. Anyways, I sure hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys haven't enjoyed this video, please make sure you hit that like button, and also don't forget to subscribe. And until then, I will see you guys in the next one. Goodbye!